Hello and welcome everyone. I'm Sonali Verma from Technical Marketing Engineering team. And in this video, we will be covering the next generation platform of PowerProtect data domain DD9410 and DD9910, which are the ultimate protection storage appliances. Dell PowerProtect DD series enables the organization to protect, manage, and recover the data at scale. As the next generation of Dell data domain appliances, DD series sets the bar for efficient data management from edge to core to cloud. DD9410 and DD9910 are the next generation market-leading best-in-class data protection storage appliances, maintaining all traditional PowerProtect DD value and features such as deduplication, compression, data invulnerability architecture, retention lock, virtual tape library, encryption, replication, smart scale, and cyber recovery support. The new platform systems are more secure using secure boot technology with root of trust capabilities, providing technology-driven performance and efficient operation. Now let's see more about hardware root of trust capabilities and how it provides the enhanced security. The hardware root of trust is a chain of trust needed to ensure computers boot with legitimate code. Silicon-based root of trust operates with immutable read-only public keys that are programmed during manufacturing. When a system boots up, it verifies the digital signature of the cryptographic hash of the boot image and matches it to the signature stored in silicon by Dell in factory. If the verification fails, system is shut down. And if the verification is successful, system continues its booting process. Dell leverages Intel bootcard technology or AMD root of trust technology in its BIOS boot process. Once bootcard finishes successfully, control is passed to the operating system or hypervisor. Starting with iDRAC 9 4.10.10.10, the BIOS image is validated at boot time. Again, the host can only boot if BIOS is validated successfully. Dell also uses iDRAC to be the security vault or to recover BIOS when it is corrupted. Therefore, hardware root of trust is also used in validating the integrity of iDRAC. A point to note here is hardware root of trust is enabled permanently on all systems. Now here's a view on the platform refresh and the software value it brings. The next generation PowerProtect data domain models DD9410 and DD9910 controllers are built on a 2U platform with dual sockets supporting Intel Xeon CPUs. We now have integrated QAT, unlike in previous generation models where we had QAT PCI card. Also with SDPM, we leverage Dell solution which replaces NVRAM hardware existing in previous generation models. The new models are based on dataless head architecture, which does not store any user data on head unit's internal drive. In both the models DD9410 and DD9910, DDoS and cache tier are configured on the head unit's internal SSD drives. There is no external disk array enclosure required to configure cache tier for standalone models, which helps to reduce the usage of rack space. There is single drive type used for active tier and cloud tier, that is 8GB.
So we can now say the new platform system enables more compression by offloading CPU workload to integrated QAT and lead to scale up performance and provides industry leading 65x deduplication. Let's see more about the integrated QAT and the value added brings.
PowerProtect Data Domain Series uses hardware-assisted technology with integrated QAT that delivers higher compression with higher performance. On DD9410 and DD9910, the hardware accelerator is integrated into the CPU. The card allows the DDoS to offload compression and decompression processes to the hardware accelerator and free up CPU resources to improve appliance performance by providing faster backups, restores, and up to 65x deduplication.
The new platforms also leverages low latency SDPM with higher capacity, which helps in protecting DD file system and assist service recovery. Now let's see how SDPM assists in service recovery. SDPM, the software-defined persistent memory, includes BIOS, memory, and CPU. On AC loss, BIOS will copy data from the DDR DIMMs to NVMe drives. All valid data on DDR memory will be flushed to NVMe drives, including data in CPU cache and I/O buffer. This process is called vault. And when system is rebooted, BIOS will also read the data on NVMe drives back to the memory. This is called the restore process. Now let's go over the hardware design for the next generation platform models, DD9410 and DD9910. Here we can see the details about the middle tier DD9410 controller and the enterprise tier DD9910 controller. Note that there's no external disk array enclosure required to configure cache tier for standalone models, and being built on 2U Dell with deep racks helps to reduce the usage of rack space up to 25%. And with dual processor 52 cores and 2048 GB memory helps in achieving fast performance for both traditional and modern workloads. With the hardware design that we have seen, we get up to 38% faster backups, 44% faster restores, 25% less rack space, and up to 11% less power consumption. And that's how we can strengthen cyber resilience foundation by leveraging these next generation data protection appliances, ensuring enhanced security, performance, and efficiency, all while controlling costs. Here's the system rear view. This shows an example of some of the different ports available in DD9410 and DD9910 models. There are 6 full height PCI slots that can be configured with variety of I/O card options, such as 4-port 10GB base D, 4-port 10 or 25GB SFP28, 2-port 100GB QSFP, or 4-port 32GB fiber channel. Note that if the system is configured for high availability, slot 7 must contain 10 or 25GB NIC. This NIC is used to link the two HA controller nodes and uses all 4 ports, 2 for heartbeat and 2 for RDMA sync of the SDPF. Then comes the OCP slot, which is at the bottom. OCP is a replacement for RNDC from the previous generation models. OCP is for general purpose I/O slot for host connections. Note that OCP port must always be filled with a card. There are 2 options for that: 4-port 10GB base D or 10 or 25GB SFP. The OCP NIC has 4 ports named ETHMA, ETHMB, ETHMC, and ETHMD. The LAN over motherboard, that is the LOM, which is at the bottom left, has only 1GB base D. These ports are not supported for general purpose I/O and are only supported for out-of-band management for those customers who desire dedicated ports. Using LOM frees up general purpose I/O ports in the OCP and PCI slots that might otherwise be used for dedicated out-of-band management by some customers. The port name comes with ETHLA and ETHLB. Now let's talk about the disk array enclosure. The new platforms will support disk array enclosure DS600 for the active tier and the cloud tier that contains multiples of 15 drives called disk packs. Each pack forms a disk group comprised of 12 disks worth of data blocks, 2 disks worth of parity blocks, and 1 drive dedicated for use as a hotspot. For all the new manufactured systems, the active and cloud tier supports DS600, which are 4U-based 60-drive enclosure. Additionally, in case of HA configuration, external disk array enclosure FS240 is required to configure cache tier. With that, let's talk about the high availability configuration. First, we will see the HA configuration that we had in previous generation model, where we had primary and secondary node, along with cache disk enclosure FS25, and there was only HA interconnect present between the two nodes. Whereas when we see the next generation platform, we see a primary node and a secondary node for high availability configuration along with cache disk enclosure, which is now FS240. Here, each HA node will have one SDPM instance. The two HA nodes connect with two RDMA, that is remote direct memory access ports, indicated by green lines, for SDPM mirroring, each having 25 gig. The two Ethernet ports bonding, indicated by red lines, are for HA existing workloads such as HA heartbeat and bulk synchronization traffic. Henceforth, the HA connections between the two nodes are primarily needed for mirroring the SDPM data, heartbeat communication, and bulk synchronization traffic. In case of HA sync, the remote direct memory access is the remote memory management capability that allows server-to-server data movement directly between application memory without CPU involvement, which leads to faster sync process. Now that we have seen all the components of the next generation platform models, let's go with the supported controller upgrade paths. Customer with older or previous generation platforms can upgrade to new models by replacing the head unit. The existing disk array enclosure that are supported in newer models are ES40, DS60, and DS600. Note that SSD shells like FS25 are not supported in controller upgrade, as well as enclosure ES30 is not supported in controller upgrade. Only disks with size 4TB and above are supported for the controller upgrade. This concludes the brief overview of the next generation platform models, that is DD9410 and DD9910. For more information, kindly go to the info hub link provided here, and you'll find white paper as well as various videos related to these next generation platforms DD9410 and DD9910. Thank you for joining today to learn all about the next generation of PowerProtect data domain.